Assalamu alaikum. In the name of Allah, the most gracious, the most merciful. This is virtual class of Pakistan International School Taif. I am Ms. Bushra Tanveer. This is Islamic Studies class for grade first year. This is our second video of this virtual class. In this video, we shall study chapter number 1, Fundamental Belief. Dear students, after today's lesson, you will be able to understand the text given in chapter number 1. You will be able to do the short question answer from the text given in the book. Dear students, today we shall continue chapter 1. The subheading which we shall study today is Shirk. Shirk, the belief in the oneness of Allah, Tawheed, is the first and foremost belief. Shirk, or the idea of anyone sharing the authority of Allah, is a later development. Meaning, shirk literally means sharing or partnership. Definition: in terms of religion, shirk means to believe and accept someone as the sharer and partner of Allah Almighty in His entity or His characteristics or the demands thereof. Dear students, here in front of your computer screen, you see the meaning of the shirk and the definition. The little explanation: the first human being on the earth, Hazrat Adam alayhis salam, the first prophet, believed in the oneness of Allah Almighty. He preached his fundamental belief to his offspring. As the human population increased and scattered, people forgot the teachings of Hazrat Adam alayhis salam and started believing in and worshipping many gods instead of one Allah Almighty. Allah Almighty sent many prophets, one after the other, to remind the people of the belief in the oneness of Allah Almighty and to condemn the idea of anyone sharing the power of Allah Almighty. Against of the teaching of the Holy Quran is as under. The first thing, that the shirk is the greatest wrong. Allah said in the Quran, Inna shirka la zulmun azim, false worship is indeed the highest wrongdoing. And the shirk is also unforgivable sin. In the Holy Quran, shirk has also been declared as the wrong that would not be forgiven. Allah said in the Quran, Inna Allaha la yaghfiru an yushraka bihi wa yaghfiru ma duna zalika liman yasha. Indeed, Allah does not forgive an association with Him, but He forgives what is less than that for whom He wills. So, dear students, it's very important for you that as a Muslim, we must believe in the oneness of Allah, and we try to avoid ourselves that we should not take or associate any partner with Allah. It is called shirk, and this is the opposite of Tawheed. And also Allah said in the Quran, the person who ascribes partner to Allah Almighty remains deprived of paradise. As the Holy Quran says, Certainly, whoever associates anyone with Allah, Allah has forbidden paradise to him. And also Allah said in the Quran, O you who believe, the associators are simply unclean. Dear students, now in the next subheading, we shall discuss about the categories or the types of shirk. There are three types of shirk, and can say there are three categories of shirk. The first one, shirk relating to his being. The second one, shirk relating to his attributes. And the third one, shirk relating to the implication of his attributes. So the first type of shirk, shirk in the entity of Allah, or shirk relating to his beings. This means the belief in the existence of someone equal to Allah Almighty, or having some physical or family relation to him. One form of this belief is to accept someone as equal to Allah Almighty, and the second form is to consider Allah Almighty as the offspring of someone, or to consider someone as the offspring of Allah Almighty. Therefore, belief in the existence of two or more gods is shirk. Similarly, to consider someone as the son or daughter of Allah Almighty is also shirk. Allah Almighty says, Lam yalid walam yulad walam yakullahu kufuwan ahad. The begetteth not, nor is he begotten, and there is none like unto him. So this is the first type of shirk, and now we shall see the next second type or the category of shirk. The shirk is in the characteristic of Allah, means shirk relating to his attributes. This means that the belief that the characteristics of Allah Almighty are possessed by someone else, or to consider that someone else possesses the same knowledge, power and will similar to Allah Almighty, or to consider someone omnipotent as Allah Almighty is shirk. Allah Almighty says in the Holy Quran, Laisa kamislihi shayun, there is nothing like him. It means that every creature is dependent on Allah Almighty, and all its qualities are granted by Allah Almighty. However, all characteristics of Allah Almighty are inherent and not granted by anyone else. Now we shall study the third type of shirk, shirk in the demand of the characteristics. Allah Almighty possesses great qualities. The demand of these qualities is that only Allah Almighty is worthy of worship and obedience. Only Allah Almighty should be the center of our obedience and love, hope and fear. It should be our faith that Allah Almighty is the provider and the sovereign. Man should follow the laws laid down by Allah Almighty. All other laws must be subservient to the laws of Allah Almighty. It is said in the Holy Quran, وَقَضَى رَبُّكَ أَلَّا تَعْبُدُوا إِلَّا إِيَّاهُ, and your Lord has commanded that you should worship none but him alone. And again, Allah said in the Quran, Wa ilahukum ilahun wahidun la ilaha illa huwa, and your Allah is one Allah, there is no God but He. And also in the next place in the Holy Quran, Allah said, and he who does not judge by that book which Allah Almighty has sent down, it is those who are the wrongdoers. And also again Allah said in the Quran, Inil hukmu illa lillah, the command is for none but Allah. So there are some disadvantages of shirk, that shirk affects human life badly. Man remains no supreme creature only because of shirk. And following are the disadvantages of shirk: loss of self-respect, narrow-mindedness, arrogance, and proud behavior, sinful life. Allah Almighty must be considered as the real provider and should offer thanks to Him sincerely. The expression of gratitude to Allah Almighty should be made in letter and spirit. We should worship only Allah Almighty, and in our life we should never consider anyone else as a sharer in the powers and authority of Allah Almighty. We should always take care that shirk is not only the worship of stone or wooden idols, but also the belief that our needs can be fulfilled by someone other than Allah Almighty. In case of very difficulty, we should seek the help and blessing of Allah Almighty, the most powerful and the most merciful. There are a large number of Muslims who verbally believe in Allah Almighty, but they beg fellow human beings to help them in their problems, like health, employment, offspring. If they had the same power and authority as possessed by Allah Almighty only, Allah Almighty described this human weakness. And also Allah said in the Quran, وَاتَّخَذُوا مِن دُونِ اللَّهِ آلِهَةً لَعَلَّهُمْ يُنصَرُونَ لَا يَسْتَطِيعُونَ نَصْرَهُمْ وَهُمْ لَهُمْ جُنْدٌ مُحْضَرُونَ. Yet they take for worship gods other than Allah, hoping that they might be helped or helpful. They have not the power to help them, but they will be brought up before our judgment seat as a troop to be condemned. And now in the next subheading, we shall study here the effect of the belief in oneness of Allah on human life. The belief in the oneness of Allah brings about remarkable and revolutionary changes in the personality of man, described as under. The first effect, self-respect. The belief in the oneness of Allah Almighty creates self-respect in man, who believes that his creator, master, source of power and sovereign is Allah Almighty. A true believer bows only before Allah Almighty and fears only Him. He has no need to degrade himself by worshipping lifeless idols or powerful human being. So this is the first effect of the belief in the oneness of Allah on the life of the human being. So the next one, the second heading, humbleness. And also we called this humility. Tawheed develops an attitudes of humility because a true believer realizes that he is helpless before Allah Almighty and everything in his possession is a gift of Allah Almighty, who is the only provider as well as depriver, therefore there is no justification for man to show arrogance. Allah said in the Quran, wa ibadur rahman allazeena yamshuna alal arzi hawnan, and the servant of Allah, most gracious are those who walk on the earth. Is humility means the person who is the most respectable in front of Allah, who shows the humbleness in front of the people in this world. The next or the third subheading, broad-mindedness. A believer in the oneness of Allah Almighty is never narrow-minded. He has firm faith in the mercy and the beneficence of Allah Almighty, who is the creator and the provider of the universe. So Allah also said in the Quran, a true believer, it is given in the book or the few explanation, a true believer possesses a universal sense of sympathy, love and service. He works for the betterment of mankind as his first and foremost ideals. The next subheading, courage and determination. And this is also called the boldness and perseverance. Courage and determination, belief in Allah Almighty makes a man brave and determined. A true believer knows that Allah Almighty is omnipotent and every object in the universe has been created by him. Therefore, only Allah Almighty is fit to be worshipped and obeyed. This belief enables the believer not to be afraid of anyone else. He becomes an embodiment of courage and determination. He is able to challenge and defy the greatest of tyrants. He becomes an image of following verse of the Holy Quran, Inna allazeena qalu rabbunallahu summastaqamu fala khawfan alayhim wala hum yahzanun. Surely those who said, our Lord is Allah, then held fast to it, they have nothing to fear, nor shall they grieve. So the next subheading, peace of mind and complete faith in Allah's will. A true believer is never disappointed and always waits for the blessing and help of Allah Almighty. He knows that Allah Almighty is always with him. Allah said in the Quran, La taqnatu min rahmatillah. Despair not of the mercy of Allah. So we shall not be disappointed any time of the mercy of Allah. Allah Almighty is the most merciful and beneficent, and his blessings are numberless. When a man seeks blessings and help of Allah Almighty, he is full of contentment. Allah said in the Quran, Ala bizikrillahi tatma'innul qulub. Listen carefully. Surely is the remembrance of Allah alone, there is the satisfaction of the hearts. The next subheading, piety. The belief in oneness of Allah Almighty creates piety in the heart of man. It is the faith of every true believer that Allah Almighty knows the innermost secrets of man. A man may be able to conceal his crimes from the eyes of other people, But Allah Almighty always has the knowledge of his deeds as well as intentions. This faith prevents a man from committing sins in public or in private and encourages him to perform good deeds. And in this subheading, Allah also very helpful, or Allah shows his pity on his human being or on his servant. And belief in the oneness of Allah Almighty creates pity in the heart of man. And this faith prevents a man from committing sin in the publicly or public place or the privately. A good human society is always based on good deeds of the people. A man can perform good actions if his heart is enlightened with the power of true faith. Dear students, now we shall see the short question answer from this material which we discussed in our today's lesson. The first question lists the fundamental Islamic beliefs. The fundamental Islamic beliefs are written as under: belief in the oneness of Allah, the Exalted; belief in the prophets of Allah; belief in the angels of Allah; belief in the books of Allah; belief in the last day; belief in the destiny, whether good or bad; belief in the life hereafter. The second part of question number one: these all beliefs are mentioned in the Holy Quran and saying of Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wa sallam, وَلَكِنَّ الْبِرَّ مَنْ آمَنَ بِاللَّهِ وَالْيَوْمِ الْآخِرِ وَمَلَائِكَتِهِ وَكِتَابِ وَالنَّبِيِّينَ. But righteousness is that one believes in Allah and the last day and the angels and the books and the prophets. Kala fakbinni anal iman, kala antuminu billahi wa malaikatihi wa kutubihi wa rusulihi wal yawmil akhiri wa tuminu bil qadri khairihi wa sharrihi. It iman is to believe in Allah and his angels, his books and his messengers and the last day, and to believe in divine destiny, both the good and evil thereof. Question number two: what is the literal and conventional meaning of Aqeedah? Literally, the word Aqeedah means to tie a knot. In Islamic view, the firm and unchangeable beliefs of a man are called Aqeedah or Aqaid. Question number three: what is the literal meaning of Tawheed? Literally, the word Tawheed means oneness or making something one. It means that Allah the Exalted is one fit and worthy to be worshipped. Question number four: what is the literal meaning of Shirk? Literally, the word Shirk means sharing or partnership. In terms of religion, Shirk means to believe and accept someone as the sharer and partner of Allah. Question number five: list the type of Shirk. There are three categories of Shirk. Number one, Shirk in the entity of Allah. Number two, Shirk in the characteristics of Allah. Number three, Shirk in the implication of the characteristics of Allah. Question number six: what does Shirk in the entity of Allah mean? This means द बिलीफ इन द एग्जिस्टेंस ऑफ सम वन शेयरिंग द पावर एंड अथॉरिटी ऑफ अल्लाह. क्वेश्चन नंबर 7, व्हाट इज द डिक्लेरेशन ऑफ होली कुरान अबाउट शिर्क. होली कुरान डिक्लेयर्स शिर्क एज अ ग्रेटेस्ट रॉन्ग डूइंग. अल्लाह सुबहान व तआला सेज इन शिर्क लजुल्म अजीम. फॉल्स वर्शिप इज इंडीड द हाइएस्ट रॉन्ग डूइंग. क्वेश्चन नंबर 8, विल द सिन ऑफ शिर्क बी फॉर गिवन. नो, अल्लाह सुबहान व तआला विल नॉट फॉर गिव एसोसिएशन ऑफ पार्टनर विद हिम. अल्लाह सुबहान व तआला सेज इन द होली कुरान इन्नल्लाह ला यग़फिर यशरिक बिही व यग़फिरु मा दून ज़ालिका लिमन यशा. श्योरली अल्लाह डज नॉट फॉरगिव दैट एनीथिंग शुड बी एसोसिएटेड विद हिम एंड फॉरगिव्स व्हाट इज बिसाइड दैट टू होम एवर ही प्लीजेस. क्वेश्चन नंबर 9, राइट सम इफेक्ट्स ऑफ तौहीद ऑन ह्यूमन लाइफ. फॉलोइंग आर सम इफेक्ट्स ऑफ तौहीद ऑन ह्यूमन लाइफ. सेल्फ रिस्पेक्ट. सेल्फ रिस्पेक्ट इज क्रिएटेड इन अ मैन हु हैज़ अ बिलीफ इन द वननेस ऑफ अल्लाह. नंबर 2, ह्यूमिलिटी. तौहीद डिवेलप्स एंड एटीट्यूड ऑफ ह्यूमिलिटी इन अ ट्रू बिलीवर. नंबर 3, कंटेंटमेंट. तौहीद मेक्स अ बिलीवर कंटेंटमेंट. He does not worry because he knows that Allah will provide for his needs if he is truly obedient. Number 4, submission. Its most important effect is that it makes a believer submissive and obedient to Allah's command. So, the homework for today, learn and write short question answers which are done today. Dear students, I think each and every topic is clear to you and every discussion or the points which we discussed in our today's lesson is clear to you. See you in the next video. Goodbye.